Yeah. Stop spreading those rumors around. The Timex Social Club. I got the P.O. here in the studio. P.O. Hill. Y'all know P.O.? Alex Hill? Yeah. And Marcus Thompson and Mike, the guy you heard on the vocals. Well, Mike's out of town, but he'll be in town soon. That's TSC, the Timex Social Club, with their brand new release called Rumors. Right? Is that the name of the record, man? Women, I didn't hear that. Is that the name of the record?
Yeah, the name of the record.
I got with me Mr. Marcus Thompson and Mr. Alex Hill, two of the three writers of the song Rumors. A lot of you heard us playing this song on the radio for the last year or so, and we've been telling you that the record was coming out, and y'all thought, oh, Nanny always was. Now I wasn't lying to you. I told you it was coming. The only reason I was telling y'all, because they was telling me, you know. So that's how come it's here, but it's out. It should be at Leopold's right now, so you can run down to the record store and buy the record. You buy everybody else's record. You better buy this record. Is that right?
Yeah, man,
that's right.
Be rich. I want to ask you, brothers, man, now you guys, y'all call yourselves songwriters. How long y'all been doing this songwriting thing, man?
Well, myself, Marcus.
Marcus, y'all.
About three and a half years.
Oh, man, What about you, Alex? How long you been writing, man?
About 2 years.
Now, I was talking to you earlier, man. You told me that sometimes you didn't even think about music. Why you say that?
Need a break.
Because you did it so much, huh?
If you keep doing it all the time, you know, you kind of get an overload. So take a break and get some fresh new ideas when you come back.
Oh! Did y'all hear that? Them fresh new ideas. Man, you guys, man, y'all got, in my opinion, the number one song in the country. It's a hot song. Everybody likes it. I wonder, what inspired y'all to write Rumors? I mean, what's going on with that?
A lot of lies.
Well, I'll tell you, Natty, it started, man, when I was at the High, Berkeley High. And,
B-Town,
Berkeley.
B-Town.
A3. Number 100. But, just hanging out my senior year and walking up and down the slopes, man. That's all I was hearing. Who did what to who and who was going with her. And, man, it's just scandalous.
Kind of got on your nerves, huh?
Yeah, man, it was something new every day, man. And it was close to home, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't escape it. I mean, I was walking by it. I had little Rumors.
On you, huh?
Yeah,
yeah, I think I heard it. Blood was one about, what's her name? Vicious Rumors, huh? Well, how did y'all, so you thought about it, and then so you did a little something with it, and then what happened?
Well, I wrote it one night at work.
Security guard.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Marcus,
you know,
is a security guard.
Trying to make the money there.
But keep the record going.
But, yeah, man, I wrote down the lyrics and conceived, like, you know, the basic beat elements of it. And I really didn't have a melody, but I had a melody.
Okay.
It was different from what you hear. Dun, 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 dun. Mike wrote that.
Okay.
But
that's Mike Marshall, right?
Yeah, he wrote that.
Okay.
I recorded on my little, you know, little cassette tape I had at work, and I let Mike listen to it because I wanted him to sing it. And he liked it.
Right.
It was the first one of mine that he liked, actually.
Right.
I saw Blood was juice, so I said, well, it's the next step. We got to take it to the hill.
Right? The hill?
Uphill music.
The pill! Uphill music! Okay.
We got to get some beat behind this.
Right.
We need a partner, so we took it to Alex, man. Things just evolved from there.
Wow. So Alex had a lot to do with that funky backbeat,
man.
We hear and them heavy drums we hear in there.
Man. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, no.
Oh, so that's the pill.
That's Alex.
I didn't have it. Oh, wow. Yeah, I remember when I first heard the tape, man, we fell in love with the tape around here, and we just kept playing it. And then I've been hearing, they said, yeah, man, the record's getting ready to come out, and man, the record is here. And there are a lot of people out there, man, who don't really have a lot of desire and really don't like to, really haven't done nothing in life and want to do something. I just really see this as a very inspiring thing. I think it's going to inspire a lot of people to really keep doing what they're doing.
Sure.
I want you guys, how many hours did y'all spend cutting Rumors, man?
Man, oh over the years.
Or a lot. Well, okay, I know as many over the, just to say the major recording session, how long was y'all in the studio? 12 hours.
Well, we was in 2 days.
Wow.
No, it was the mix down was a whole day. Yeah. One day just do the mix down.
So all day y'all just hearing the same record.
Six a.m. to seven p.m.
Woo!
The original recording session was about 12 hours, and the mix down was almost seven hours.
Mm-hmm. Now y'all got a producer. Y'all had another. I know all you guys eventually would probably be producing your own stuff, but on this particular disc, man, you had a producer. Well, tell us a little bit about him.
About Frost from Alaska?
Jay King.
From Alaska, Anchorage. The man is small, but he got a good ear.
Got a good ear.
He's one big ear. No, he's a good dude, though. He put the money up for it. He believed in us. You know?
Yeah.
Finally somebody believed in us.
Yeah.
A lot of people kind of believed in us, but they didn't want to.
Yeah, they didn't want to take no risk. No chance.
This man, you know, he
thought it was another song. It's the ordinary song. Oh, yeah. Keep striving there, guy. Really good sound there.
Yeah.
And, they heard it, you know. It's 3 weeks later, we're in the studio.
Yeah.
Months later, the record's out.
So right.
He went right at it.
Yeah, and that was an important part. Him going, seeing that y'all was serious and him being as serious as y'all was about y'all thing. But more importantly, having the money to put up into that thing.
Right.
They tell me there's a whole bunch of paperwork involved in that thing, man.
Yeah, man. It was
signing this, signing that. You didn't sign your life away, did you?
Oh, no.
I signed one record away.
Yeah, I noticed, man.
Definitely
that,
don't do that, y'all. Don't
never sign
don't
your life
up,
away,
man.
Yeah, because for those of y'all who don't know, the record says Vicious. It says Rumors, and then underneath it says Marcus Thompson and Mike Marshall and Alex Hill, and then it says Timex Social Club. So it seemed to me like y'all got a whole lot of that record is on y'all. Huh?
We got the copyright paper.
Yeah. Copyright
First
paper.
And foremost,
what's a copyright paper?
That's what the Library of Congress gives you to give you proof that the song is yours.
Right. And y'all can get those. We got a little information on that. But for all you potential songwriters, y'all think y'all just supposed to just make your beat and start putting your tapes out there?
Yeah, don't put your tape out there. Don't send your tape to
nobody. If I hit and you ain't got a copyright,
because quiet is kept. I remember the first time Alex came by here with some of his new stuff. He didn't want to leave his tape with me.
Yeah.
He says, "Oh, maybe you can play it and I can take it home." I said, "Alex, what you mean, man? I ain't gonna take your music." He says, "Man, maybe you can just play it and I can take it with me, man. I ain't gonna leave my tape, man. I ain't leaving my tape." Yeah.
No, man, you got to be up on it nowadays, man. It's just like the old days, man. You get ripped off and
right.
You won't even know it, man.
Them song sharks out there.
Yeah, because I remember, man,
that's
first.
How people make their money in L.A., man.
Yeah, because I heard at first, man, not to slight y'all producer or none, but at first, he came at y'all about putting it on the back of another record, huh?
Yeah, man.
That was kind of it. I know that kind of sounded strange to you, huh?
Yeah. He had this group, right? From Anchorage, and they hadn't done nothing, man, in over a year or something like that. And they was shopping a new project, right?
Right.
And Bud came all out the woodwork, and he was juiced, you know. And I was a little juiced, man, but I was like, damn.
Because I know I got mad when I heard about that.
Well, you know, yeah, he's kind of like, he's cool, but he's kind of like, if he wants something his way, he wants it his way.
Yeah,
I mean, it's like, I'm supposed to do my own thing next month, my single.
Yeah.
Myself, but you know, if he don't want to do it the way I want to do it, we're not going to do it.
Yeah, because it's not about just being so juiced about getting the record out.
Right.
Because y'all learning now that it's easy to get a record. All you need is a few thousand dollars.
Yeah.
You know, you can raise those, you know, so that's what that's all about, man. But that was interesting. Like I said, I just brought that point up because a lot of times people kind of compromise what they believe in.
We compromised a little bit on this.
Yeah.
Well, I sort of told him, it was all or nothing thing.
Let's put it this way.
What do you mean by compromise? What do you mean? How did you compromise?
There was almost a guitar in the song.
Yeah, I heard about that, man.
No.
And we went there, we told him, we said, "Look, the guitar ain't gonna work." And he's like, "No, I want it'll sound good with a guitar. It'll sound funky. It'll sound good." So we got this guy in the studio.
Yeah.
And listened to about 3 hours, they finally decided no guitar.
Right. But there's a guitar track.
There's a guitar track on the master tape, so we can go back and remix the rock version.
Yeah.
Because they got a screaming guitar in it.
Oh, okay.
So you can imagine Mike singing.
Boy, Mike cross over.
The crossover to the heavy metal station.
Right. So you say that y'all compromising that y'all allowed them to at least experiment doing.
Well, we
that
couldn't up. Even. I mean, it's like, you know, well, the guy's putting the money up in the way. He got to say, but
yeah,
it didn't have to be like that.
But y'all was adamant, right, about not having a guitar, right?
We were, but he was adamant about having it.
Right. But he had to learn from
listening to.
I figure it's his money he wasted.
Yeah.
It ain't on there.
I look at it this way: if the record don't sell, I did at least accomplish something I want to do.
Yeah.
And I don't lose a dime.
Right.
If the he don't sell the record, he's lost up to like $20,000.
Yeah, so, yeah. That's real. Did y'all hear that? These brothers are some pretty smart businessmen to me. You know, they made a very sound.
About getting what you want, man.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Don't let nobody in this game.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, because everybody trying to get there.
Don't let nobody, you know, tell you what you're gonna do with your if something is yours.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
know. Don't yeah. let nobody walk up to you and say, "Give you your money."
Yeah.
You
know, right.
If it's yours, I mean, you want to fight for it, man, you got to.
Yeah, that's real, man.
Especially your songs, you know, you can't let black people take yourself. Your songs.
Yeah.
Especially, and change your songs around. They'll try to change it.
Yeah, to what they hear. And they don't even know what inspired you to write the thing.
Right.
You know, they don't know about all of
them. It doesn't mean the same thing to you that you meant when you wrote it, because it's so different.
Yeah, yeah.
So you don't want to do that.
Y'all heard all them rumors everybody was spreading. I heard about you too, Alex. Don't be trying.
Ain't no rumors about me. Ain't no rumors about me.
Up in East Down, all down the coast.
Right, so I'm just
everybody
saying.
Know
right, now I have one more question, man. If you guys had any really serious advice about, because y'all know you guys got some fresh stuff y'all gonna got coming out. Like Alex,
oh, yeah, man.
Alex just said that he's
look out, man.
Alex just said that he getting to go in and do his own solo release.
Freaky Mind, Freaky Mind.
Yeah, this man got a sound you wouldn't believe.
Mm.
Me too. Now I'll be out later.
Right.
Yeah, Freaky Mind will be out in a couple months.
Heard y'all got a background female vocalist that's pretty hot.
Yeah, man, we about to change some things in this industry.
Oh,
man.
It sounds good to me.
Got a girl that sings with me named Valerie Watson, goes to Stanford.
Yeah.
And she can sing.
So everybody's throwing that Minneapolis sound. They better watch out for B-Town, huh?
Yeah, right. We're
taking people with us, too.
Up.
The local people around us. I'm taking them with me. I got some rappers taking with me.
Up.
Yeah, man.
People out there I know, my friends.
Right.
They write songs. Got a friend, Kevin Moore. He writes songs.
Right.
Taking them with me.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about. You got to take people with you.
Yeah, yeah, because it's kind of get kind of lonely at the top.
All that,
well, not just that. You don't want to get to the top on top of people.
Oop! Did y'all hear that one? You don't want to get on the top on top of people, because everybody's helped. Everybody inspires. What you did may have been the reason why you wrote what you wrote. Mm-hmm. You know, that's real, man. Rumors.
You need that home connection, man. How you gonna write with somebody you don't know?
Yeah, keep it.
How can you collaborate, man?
Right.
They don't have the same.
They don't know
environment
you
have. You know, they didn't grow up with you. They don't.
Yeah.
From the same surroundings.
Yeah,
stuff.
Yeah. They don't even know. They don't know what you go out and see look out and see every day when you wake up in the morning.
Yeah.
Living in Berkeley is different from living anywhere.
I mean, this ain't Des Moines, Iowa. You know.
Yeah.
We ain't writing potato songs.
Back on the farm.
Right. Right.
Cook me a potato.
For those of you who just tuned in, we're live here with Mr. Alex Hill.
Live.
With Mr. Alex.
It's Saturday night.
With Mr. Marcus Thompson and Mr. Alex Hill of Timex Social Club. And y'all know our own Mike O'Marshall. And their brand new release has just come out.
Yeah. Sound like a machine gun, don't it?
Yeah, right. And
I am.
they got their totally hot new 12-inch out called Rumors. Rumors, stop spreading those lies.
To that vicious side.
Matter of fact, we get ready to go to that vicious side right now. So we want all of y'all to
turn that radio up.
Turn that radio up and buy the record. Buy the record.
What you want, man?
We want a house in Kensington so you can come visit us.
Don't tell me where we live, man.
Oh, we're not living in there.
Maserati.
So we want y'all to out there stay tuned for Vicious Rumors.